What is going on, everyone? Prestige here, bringing up some number 35 of The Road to Gold. And this time, I'll be covering the DSR-50 bolt-action sniper rifle, customized with ballistic CPU, laser, and fast mag attachment, playing some team deathmatch on Raid. I hope you all enjoy the gameplay and commentary. Without further ado, let's begin. And a lot of my subscribers had pointed out that I did a Road to Diamond for the DSR-50, but I never did the Road to Gold. So in this episode, I'm going to be covering the defensive playstyles of a sniper. In the Road to Diamond, I covered the aggressive playstyles of a sniper, the run-and-gun snipers, the quick scopers. If you want to see that video, it's down below in the description. I provided a URL. Just click on that. It'll take you directly to the video. But in this episode, we're going to take a seat and look at the snipers that like to actually play old school. I'm talking about the people that like to use their scopes, the people that like to stay hidden off the radar and pick off their enemies like a ghost. And that is just a perfect way to describe it. If you're one of those players and you're wondering, what game mode should I play to get my bloodthirsties? This is also an easy way to get your bloodthirsties. Keep that in mind. What game mode should I play to get my one-shot kills? If you're going to be a defensive sniper, make sure you're playing objective game modes like domination, demolition, capture the flag, things that you can watch your objective and wait for your enemies to come to you. It is a perfect way to get your bloodthirsties, your one-shot kills. It's also a perfect way to learn how to snipe and get a little better at quickscoping if you feel like trying it out. This is going to be a perfect class setup for that as well. Starting with these perks. Perk number one, lightweight and ghost. Stay off the radar and stay mobile if you like to. Once you get to your position, your lightweight and ghost really won't come in handy. Second tier slot will be cold-blooded, just to keep your name off the radar. You most likely won't be getting fired at from enemies because they won't be able to see you if you're in a certain position. And your third perk slot, dexterity, just to climb objects faster and reach your objective faster as well. It'll be able to just climb through windows, ledges, things like that, and get to a certain sniping position that you want to be in. Attachments-wise, this is going to be a little different. And a lot of you might not agree with these, but attachments are definitely up to you. Perk setup is definitely up to you. These are just my opinions, and it's been working very well for a lot of people. These are attachments that come in handy when you're learning to quickscope. These are attachments that come in handy when you want to actually try to stay off the radar and get your bloodthirsties. Starting with attachment one will be your ballistic CPU. If you're planning on aiming down your sight for a long period of time, it'll help with weapon sway. Second attachment would be suppressor. Keep in mind, it is a one-shot kill from the chest and above. Anything below will be a two-shot kill. Unless they're already damaged, you'll still get a one-shot kill. And then your final perk would be extended mags. Extended mags will help you pick off more enemies at once, and you won't have to reload as often. It's just an awesome setup, and I personally like using it in Search and Destroy. But once again, like I said, you can even play Ground War, Domination, Demolition, Capture the Flag. Try to stick to objective game modes where you can help your team by keeping people off the objective and stuff like that. If you're an aggressive sniper, you know, try game modes like Search and Destroy, Team Deathmatch, Kill Confirmed. Those are fun game modes to go over to. I went over it in the Road to Diamond. I won't touch base on it here. But things like that, and I don't know if you've noticed this, but if you're an old school Call of Duty sniper, or you've been in Call of Duty games for a while, I mean, I'm talking like all the way back to the original Call of Duty. When the multiplayer hit, there are maps and just modes that had, like, the maps in original Call of Duty games were a lot bigger than the maps in Black Ops 2. And the first thing that I noticed was when I picked up a sniper in Black Ops 2, like, man, this is just is really difficult to get one-shot kills. It's really difficult to get kills in general with these tight corridors. You have to, like, literally wait for your chance to see a long target like you see right here. But if you're playing games like on Dome, or not Dome, on Drone, or even Turbine, those are sniping maps. Those are straight-up sniping maps. You got long-range kills right there. And this is just a completely different ball game when you're playing, like, Raid or, I mean, I see snipers on Nuketown, and it's like, really? Come on. If you've ever played Nuketown, by the way, and I kind of want to bring this up for a second, Nuketown from the original Black Ops compared to Nuketown from the new, like, Black Ops 2, it almost seems like the original Nuketown is a little bigger. Like, all the maps got scaled down or something in this game, it feels like, to me at least. I don't know if any of you have noticed that. Like, it almost seems like the compared to Turbine is a huge map to some people. But there are maps on original Call of Duty games, I mean a little bit older, like World at War, for example. There are maps on there that are way bigger than Turbine. Way bigger than Turbine. And it's like way more open area too. There isn't a bunch of rocks, you know, a downed turbine in the middle of the map. It's like just pure open area. And that's actually when we had tanks, vehicles that we could use in the multiplayer. And that was a long time ago. I don't know if any of you remember that, but I always got pissed off at the tank users. But guys, I kind of went off subject there. I hope you enjoyed this episode of The Road to Gold. If you did, please drop a like. If not, that's cool. Keep in mind, I am on the road to 100,000 subscribers. If you'd like to hit that subscribe button, please feel free to do so. And if you want to see another Road to Gold, let me know what weapon you want to see down below in the comments section. Also, let me know what weapon you want to see for the Road to Diamond. Until next time, everyone, I am out. Peace.